Hello and welcome. My name is Manuel Quintana with Pragmatic Works, and in collaboration with MAQ Software, we're bringing you today's video to showcase their ring chart custom visual. And although it will look like a donut chart, it's far richer and has far more features than the out-of-the-box donut chart. So let's go and explore the ring chart visual by MAQ Software in Power BI. All right, so here we are looking at the ring chart custom visual by MAQ Software. And if we select this visual, we're going to see that we have quite a few options to map fields to here. And the primary elements that we're needing is pretty much just a primary measure. That's all that's required. And you want to associate a legend along with it. This kind of falls in line with a traditional donut chart. But just from looking, we can see a couple of things. There's a nice summary right in the center. We're going to talk about that in a little bit. We also have this nice animation element as the pieces kind of pop out as they do it. And there's some great there's a lot more functionality to come. The first thing to take note of, you might have already seen it because of all the extra fields we have capable of mapping, is that our ring chart has the capability of tracking two separate measures. And each of those measures can actually have differing thresholds. And that's going to be we're going to leverage inside of this summary section. So first, we can see in the legend just at the top here that we have both of our measures. So in this case, we have sales accepted lead and sales qualified lead. And we can see that relevant information just here. We also can, within the tooltip, it'll give us that information. We notice the animation is not turned on here, but we also have a primary threshold and then a secondary threshold. There's actually multiple ways we can achieve this. And we're going to have to go into the format area to see where we can take advantage. So we can actually populate this and have the threshold be controlled by another field, another column, or you actually have the capability of doing this manually, which is how I'll show you this. So if we go into the field section here, we can see there's lots and lots of different options. It should be noted that we can manipulate the legend as far as positioning and move it around to 8 different spots here. We're going to leave it as is. We do have the capability of controlling the various different colors for our data labels here for what we see in our legend. And then if we go, and this is where it gets critical, on our summary labels. So we have the first one here for our primary summary label and our secondary. So by kind of modifying these, we can just turn it on and off and we have these items in the middle. But then individually, we can go into the primary versus secondary indicators. Now, if we turn this on and we don't have anything mapped in those fields in the beginning, well, both of them are going to be showing green because we're basically saying anything that's a value greater than nothing, and this has a value, so it's green. But if we go into these items, we can see that we have this capability of saying sign in indicator. If we turn this is going to mean it's going to be based off of, we're going to leverage what is being used in the mapped fields because we don't have anything. I'm going to turn this off and I'm going to say, hey, for this one, you know, the threshold value should be 4,000. Now the value here, if we hover over this, of course, is less. We can see it's 2653. There's some rounding going on here, which we can change and amend, but it's not meeting our total value threshold. Now notice there's a threshold and total value. So if you want to kind of create a range where it needs to fall between this, you can. But if I bump this down, we'll go back to green, let's say. Now I'll leave this top one red just so we have a little bit of variety in this item. Now, of course, when we go into here, we have the summary labels here. This is where we can choose. Right now, I can remove this and say none, so we see that 2653. And at the bottom, I've already actually done that for our secondary summary labels, where I've removed the display units, where it was basically just rounding that. So here, we get a little more freedom, a little more control, and we can dictate how each of these individual measures will be, how the indicators will change depending on our threshold, whether defined by a field or done manually. Lots and lots of various different choices that we have in here. Now, very common, of course, is going to be our labels. And we have quite a few options we can do. Currently, if we look at this visual here, we can see we're just displaying the value as well as the category, which if we scroll down, we can see the label style. But we have a ton of different choices in this location. Just category, keeping it simple. If we want everything with the percentages and the values, of course, we can do that. It's really dealer's choice here. So you have lots of options for controlling around this donut, around this ring chart. What values do we want represented in there? Lots and lots of choices. Of course, reiterating this just because of the fantastic nature of it is our legend, right? We can have those measures according to the legend. It is here. We can see all of that information and all of those details. Now, We also have some specific items that we can set up in regards and basically have support for negative values. So if we go and we leverage this ring chart and we have negative values that are bringing you back, so we can see we have our measure here is simply called value, and we have our category, which is just a list of letters, while D and E, those are going to be, of course, significantly, they're going to be negatives. I'm just going to increase the size here so we can see this a little bit better for us. And then we can see, because we have that capability, that D and E, we have set up this support to basically have a fill pattern. That is one choice that we can have. And let's look at this, right? We can see the animation is still in place. We have this really nice fill pattern. Under negative value arc settings, this is where we can choose the positioning. So right now, it's standard. It's part of the ring. But if we want, we can have this be outset. So we can go here and just switch this to pop out and drop in. And we can see them both side by side right here. Popping out leaves them. The animation aspect goes away. And what we have is the capability where it's just stuck out there versus drop in, it's indented and sunk in there. Now to control if you wanted that little animation look and feel, once again in the format area, once we're in here, we can go into the, if we keep looking down here, the animation settings, we can turn this on and now we get this little pop out. Basically that's what it does. If it's already in the pop out, well, it pops out a little bit more. Same for everything else. So you can turn that on, turn it off, put some default behaviors if we wanted to for the negative items. Of course, you know, the shading there, we can have that item in the negative value arc settings where we can have a pattern fill or not, where it's just using the positioning. But I really like the pattern fill. This really brings attention to it. These are negatives, which is what we want. We want that to be displayed. This is different. So all within this format area, so many different ways to take a very mundane, a very traditional donut chart. But as you can see, we can add so much more and add so much more value into the mix here. Not to mention, if for any reason you have some categories that have no returned value, so there's no data, you can have a message appear in place of that, which is just another great added feature to this ring chart by MAQ Software. Well, thanks for watching our video. If you have any questions about this visual or need a similar business solution, feel free to contact MAQ Software at sales@maqsoftware.com. As well, for any of your Power BI training needs, be sure to reach out to us at Pragmatic Works by emailing training@pragmaticworks.com.